Hello, good evening and welcome to this edition of the program. Well, a lot happening since Tuesday that we take a look at the case of Mr. Kennedy Agyapong. Quite a bit has been happening, and tonight his release was finally secured by his lawyers. Tonight we will have a look at that. But let's hear his victory speech, if you can call it that, tonight about 3-4 hours ago at the party office. Here it is. We'll bring you that in a little while. Let me just run you through the order that we have today. So we saw you the victory speech, and in our research ahead of the program tonight, we noticed that apart from this treason trial, if it ever turns out to be, there's been another significant treason trial in the history of this country in 1963. We'll share that with you, involving President Nkrumah at a time when a bomb was thrown at him in Kolongogo. We'll talk about that in a bit. But also, lead counsel for Ken Agyapong, Mr. Atta Akyea, has graciously accepted to give us the story of what has been happening going on since last Monday. His associates in his office tonight told us that he's been in the office for the last 4 days, and Atta has graciously accepted to speak with us tonight. He'll be in the studio to tell us the story of the last few eventful hours in his life as a lawyer, and a very seasoned and experienced one at that. As you would know, Atta Akyea is also a member of parliament for Ebuakwa South, and therefore a colleague member of parliament to Ken Agyapong, who turned out to be his client over the last few hours. And then Angela Jamina Abuaje is the spokesperson of a coalition of NGOs. She would also be joining us to tell us how they receive this information and what is their view going forward on how political actors should conduct themselves ahead of this year's election. Do we have Kennedy Agyapong's speech tonight at the party office? We'll take that, and then we'll do a bit of history lessons here. And it's interesting to note that some of the personalities in that treason trial included Obechebe Lamte, who was linked to the trial, but in fact was not actually on trial. Komla Gbedema, who was himself a member of the CPP before, but at that time he had become a member of the opposition because he had left Ghana. Let's hear Kennedy Agyapong, and then we'll come to the history.
Party for Machinado. Party for Ghana for Machinado Kessie. Mammy, who said, Ope, maybe I didn't look at you. Now, me peer by Matisse and Yanumbi, me who don't you know, a bit more. A paper, Masramo, Samunya Butre, Omwe Pranoso, a free watching a corner, Masramo Bia Bako Bako. Medikai, Meda Judicial Service Nasi. Oshia court no a o ma kire se o mo ma embra ye adwuma amaye awirehiem se ohia ni didi osikani su didi a police fonso first no me ni didi e wo mu bakakrai amme hu se se ye ma won kwan se o mu nya adwuma o mu be ye adwuma pa. And to me da a police force was say me da me party lawyers akesia ah and we are not only adopt no Agyapong, asoma mi kani se, mi ni tribe ubiya hutan, ni amika chila muni se, meti honu meti, mi wohani yesi, makase mi, yenko kume igbefuo, enyanu kule, mi ujina hai, mi ma, muntie ni ye, Muntie ni ye nuanom Ni amadwene ye me ni se NDC fo fi se Voter regi wo mu ye lusu Enti wo mu pe se wo mu capitalize on asema me ka ye Enti nuanom mislamu Nuanom mislamu Me menu ka sei me ma enan en wo mu free adidomi Enti me ni obi ya hotan Mini and Crafton Hutan, Mini before Hutan. Niamh Chiramwani said, Medobia Waganaha. I stand for the truth, freedom, equality, justice, and peace for everybody in this country. Medamasa.
So that was Kennedy Agyapong. It was a speech that he gave at the party office earlier today. You can decide to call it a victory speech, or you can decide to call it a reassurance speech. But those of you who don't understand the language, I will do well to translate the most important portions. He thanked the judiciary for their professional attitude, and he also thanked the police and indicated that if the police in Ghana were given the wherewithal and were given the opportunity to work, he believes with his experience with them that they would deliver a perfect job to Ghana. So those were the two important matters. He also denied that he is a tribalist and indicated that indeed four of his biological children come from the Volta region in a town called Ajidome. And so he is not a tribalist. He also said that the government party, the NDC, are beginning to be wary, according to him, of a potential defeat in the Volta region, and that they were applying what he said to regain grounds in the Volta region. Those were Kennedy Agyapong's words in a paraphrase form for you. So we will continue with this program, but just lest I forget, last night an African brother, Didier Drogba, did us proud, didn't he? I mean, he thumped Chelsea, the English Premier League team, with a fighting chance to get into the Champions League final. And he held the team together and did a lot of the work. Drogba was many people's man of the match. And I think that for an African coming from Ivory Coast, we're all very proud of his performance. Here is a 15-second shot just to remind you of what the African brother did far away in England last night.
Chip. Chelsea did score against the run of play in first half stoppage time. Frank Lampard, Robin Messi, before he picked out Ramirez, who supplied Drogba with the cross to score. For the chip. Chelsea did score against the run of play in first half stoppage time. Frank Lampard, Robin Messi, before he picked out Ramirez, who supplied Drogba with the cross to score.
For the chip. Congratulations to Didier Drogba, and our own Michael Essien was on the bench. We wish him speedy recovery. We hope that in the next leg, Michael Essien will be able to play, and he, together with Drogba, will do a good job to show as Kwame Nkrumah said, that after all, the black man is capable of managing his own affairs. That was for football. But listen to this story just before Atacha joins us into the studio to talk about what has been happening. And later on, if you're just joining us, Angela Jamuna Abuaji will be my other guest in the studio. Angela will be talking about the view of the coalition of NGOs and how they see this year's election. Many people have said that the NGOs and the civil society are an important part of the process. We need to hear from them. We need them to be impartial, and we need them to say it as it is, to call a spade, and to speak the truth. Well, yesterday, the coalition came together and issued a statement. Angela Jamuna Abuaji will join us to tell us that. But listen to the story. It may not be familiar to most of you who are below the age of 50, like I am, but here it is. On the 27th of July, 1962, the president of Ghana, Dr. Kwame Nkrumah, left Accra for Kumasi to attend the annual Congress of the Convention People's Party, of which he is the general secretary, and this was written in that time. So Kwame Nkrumah was the general secretary of the Convention People's Party, and he proceeded on the 31st of July, 1962, to Tengundu in the Republic of Upper Volta for a meeting with the president of Upper Volta. In his entourage were, among ministers and high officials of the Convention People's Party, one Mr. Taria Adamafio. He was the third accused person in this matter. Mr. Akowaje, whom we all know now, we have the Akowaje interchange. Mr. Akowaje was the fourth accused person in this matter. Mr. Kofi Crabb was a fifth accused person in this matter. The president, the story goes on, left Tengkundu on the afternoon of the 1st of August, 1962, on his return journey back to Ghana. His route went through Kulungugu, a village in the Upper East region, at which he was not scheduled to stop. Note that His Excellency the President, Dr. Nkrumah, was not scheduled to stop in Kulungugu. However, when he arrived at Kulungugu, the President's car was hailed to stop by the local district commissioner and some other persons said to be standing in the middle of the road. And a request was made to the President to come down and inspect a guard of honor made up of school children who had gathered to welcome him on his return from Upper Volta. The president's car was not supposed to stop. It was not due to stop. It was hailed to stop by the district commissioner and other persons. And Osagyefo was told that school children and some other people had mounted a guard of honor, and they would very much like to welcome him from Upper Volta. So President Nkrumah obliged. Hear the story. No sooner had the president stepped out of his car and taken a few steps in the direction of the school children than a loud explosion was heard. It was later found out that the explosion was a hand grenade which had been dropped a few yards from H.E. the president. Several persons, including a school child, were killed and many were wounded, some of them very seriously. The president himself, the report said, was also wounded. The prosecution in this case made the case that the throwing of the hand grenade at Kulungugu was the consummation of the object of treason, in which all the persons, together with other persons named in the indictment, and other persons who were not even named, were privy to. The evidence of the prosecution is that both was both direct and circumstantial, and Justice Corsa said he will refer to it in his case, which I've just been reading. So that was one of the high-profile treason trials that occurred, perhaps the last one that occurred in 1963, I should say. So the three judges who heard this matter included Edward Akufo-Addo and Chief Justice Sir Akko Korsah, and also Justice Van Leer. Now, hear the verdict of the court that find Taria Adamafio, the third accused person, not guilty. Now, the first accused person was one man called Benjamin Otchere, no relation to me, I should say. He was a member of parliament for Adanse in Ashanti. He was a member of parliament for the United Party. And the other person was Mr. Yao Menu, who was a civil servant, and who was also thought to have close links to the UP. They were the first two accused persons. Both of them were found guilty of treason by the court. But about the other three, here is what the court said. We therefore find Taria Adamafio, the third accused person, not guilty on both counts in the indictment and discharge him accordingly. We find that Mr. Akowaje, the fourth accused person, is also not guilty, and we therefore discharge him accordingly. And we therefore find also that Mr. Hughes Horatius Kofi Crabb, the fifth accused person, not guilty on both counts and discharged them accordingly. Now, what was the reaction of our famous president, Dr. Nkrumah? He fired all three judges. He sacked them. Chief Justice Akko Korsah was sacked. Mr. Justice Van Leer was sacked. Mr. Edward Akufo-Addo was sacked on the basis that they had not ruled the matter well. He thought that they had been lenient to people who had connections and links with the United Party. But Akwaje was a minister in the CPP, and Terry Adamafi was also a minister.